So this is our newest machine. This is our Rustler 280 Pro, 280 amp max output, 200 amps at 60% duty cycle. And the idea is to just get back to something a little simpler. Multi-process machines were the craze for a while. Everybody wanted the new shiny thing. And a lot of people are realizing that all I'm ever going to do is MIG weld. So we got this one. This is going to be, it's going to run on 208 or 230 single phase power only. No pulse. We do have a pulse version coming out later in the year. But for now, this is going to be CV only. Again, pretty simple. It comes pretty much as shown off the skid. It does have a gun holder and a cable holder that come in the box. You just have to take a couple screws out, put them back on because it ships better with them off, but those are included. Comes with gun, ground clamp, flow meter, gas hose, pretty much everything you need other than wire and gas. And I happen to know a place you can get that. So there's an optional toolbox that you can put on here. Just like the cable holder, you remove the screws, put the toolbox on, so then it fastens right down to the top of the machine. It's a steel toolbox that does have a hasp on it so you can lock it, and it has dividers in it so you can keep all your extra knickknacks in there. Front display is pretty simple, straightforward. Full digital green just for high visibility. Very simple two knob control, which a lot of people like. Wire free speed and volts. So even though it's simple, we do have a few options here. So in my selector screen here, I can scroll down so I can go to trigger lock, which we refer to it as 2T and 4T. So that's just basically a trigger lock. So if you're doing long welds, you can let off the trigger and ease up on forearm fatigue. We do have inductance control, so we can adjust that plus or minus from a zero point. So depending on what type of wire you're using, stainless wires, for example, solid wires like a little bit higher inductance, so you can tweak and tune that. We've got burn back adjustment, so we can change our burn back time, crater fill time, post flow gas, our material type. So we've got mild steel, aluminum, copper, stainless, or flux core. And then next we're going to have our gas type, either CO2 or MAG, which stands for mixed argon gas. So not necessarily a MAG gas, but a mixed argon gas. So 75-25, for example. Wire diameter, 30, 35, and 40, 45. And then we can change the display if amps or wire feed speed. And then in units, inches per minute or meters per minute. Now, even though we can tell the machine that we're running different material types, different wire diameters, different gas types, it's not a true synergic mode. We're just adjusting slope parameters in the background of the machine to optimize the arc. So it's still a two knob machine. So somebody that doesn't want to get into the nitty gritty of it. Front panel here is basically our power block connector. So if we're running electrode positive, we would just have this in the bottom position. If we were going to run a self-shielded cord wire where you're going to run electrode negative, then you would just switch that over. So easy change out there, just a 50 mil DINS connector, DINS style. And then we can hook up a spool gun to this. It is spool gun capable or ready. So as soon as you plug in a spool gun, it's going to recognize that. And then you'll have wire feed speed and control from your spool gun, and you'll be ready to roll if you want to run, say, aluminum on a spool gun. We'll load some wire on this guy. But I guess before we load the wire, we'll talk about inside the cabinet here a little bit. So this machine comes with our four-roll industrial drive stand. This is the exact same drive stand that's in all of our heavy industrial product machines. So this thing is rock solid, and it's built to last. We've got color-coded drive rolls. So color-coded for diameter, 035, 040. Yellow is 045. It comes with two sets of drive rolls. 035, 045, and then also an 030, 035 set of drive rolls. Then just lock that back into place with a little turn of the locking nut here. So put our wire on. This is just 035 S6. And it is a left-handed nut, so when you put that back on, just make sure it's stamped on there, but that doesn't mean that'll necessarily be recognized. Make sure that's nice and snug. Brake tension is just an 8 millimeter Allen key in here, so you can adjust your brake hub tension. So this is just 035 copper-coated S6 wire, nothing special. But one of the really cool features about this drive stand is the way we've designed this. So inside here, we've got a jog button and a gas purge button. And what most people are used to doing is opening the drive rolls and trying to get their fingers in there and finagle it all around. The way we've designed this is I just get the wire started in there, hit the jog button and let the drive rolls pull the wire right through. Works every time. Leave that down to hook the gun up. Usually what I like to do is feed out a little bit of wire here first to get it started into the gun. And then in here, just want to make sure you loosen the set screw up. Be careful because it will come all the way out. But you want to make sure that's out so you can, so I can lock the gun in completely. Then just tighten that thumb screw back down so my gun doesn't pull out. Be surprised at how many people forget to do that. And then they complain because it worked great for a while. And then all of a sudden they didn't have any shielding gas anymore. Close this guy back up. So this is our Spraymaster gun. This is the 250 amp version. It comes with the machine. And this comes with what we call our velocity consumables. So this is relatively new. And our velocity consumables, it's two piece instead of three piece. So you've got your nozzle, then you've got the contact tip, and that's it. So there's no brass diffuser in between. That's a copper to copper ball and socket connection. So it improves your arc stability because of the electrical conductivity through copper to copper. And the gas flows through the knot or through the contact tip here. So it helps keep it cool. And because of the alloys that we use, these last significantly longer than a lot of your traditional tips. That little line is to tell me where I'm supposed to cut the liner on the nozzle. So we know where to cut that. Put the nozzle or the contact tip back in, and then the nozzle locks it into place. So then you're ready to go. These come in medium and heavy duty, and they're marked by two stripes. The two knurled bars are medium duty. If it was heavy duty, there'd be a third knurled bar and a third stripe on the contact tip. So now that we got that in, we got the gun plugged in, we'll feed wire through it and we'll be ready to rock. So it will jump into a jog mode and the wire finally comes out. In the process of that, what just happened was I did get an error because I was feeding wire for so long, or the machine, I was holding the trigger down, the machine recognized there was no arc, so it just errored out. So I just let off the trigger, hit the trigger again if I want to feed the wire that way, or I could use that internal jog button to feed the wire out. And with that, after we put gas up, we're ready to weld. So hang that guy there. Utilize our handy dandy cable holder over there for now. And next up will be hooking gas up.